dream. I was poor because I didn't have anything. I had no money, I had no things, we had no TV, we had no refrigerator, we had nothing as kids. But I was rich because I had a dream.
If you give up on your dreams, if you give up on your dreams, what do you have left? Nothing.
I mean, if you go back to the Arnold days and you watch those guys train, I mean, they would spend 3 hours in the gym. Probably overtrain themselves, but they loved doing it. That's why they were there. Arnold was winning $500 at the Mr. Olympia. I don't know if people know that. They were laying bricks and, you know, drinking milk and shit while they were getting ready for the show. So it was very difficult for them to make a living at it, and the prize money was shit. But they still, that just proves, like, that was the passion of the golden era of bodybuilding, is like, they didn't care about the money. They did it because they loved to train.
It was so much fun and enthusiasm. It was incredible.
And we used to live together. We had 2 bedrooms, a little apartment. And in the morning was like, he was the guy that, he gets up 6:30, Franco, get up, do the protein drink. And I'm going like this, you know, putting the eggs in the protein drink. And then we would go there, drink the protein drink, get in the car and go to the gym. It was like a continuous routine for years, and paid off later that we were the best of all times in bodybuilding, with no question.
It's always been about the love of the game and the energy I gained from it.
The heart, the passion, the love, the commitment, and the energy you're willing to put into it, that is bodybuilding. That's bodybuilding. That's what it's always has been, and people forgot.
Big visions, but I think that there was definitely no one around that believed in me.
Everyone was basically, you know, laughing at me, at those ideas.
The hunger and the desire and this burning desire inside, that I want to be somebody and I want to make it and I want to be the best.
First of all, you have to understand my mentality. I love feeling like an outsider. I never want to be one of a million. If I wanted to be one of a million, I would have never got the body that I got.
I can't live that way. I can't live that way. I have to live on the edge. But I like being uncomfortable. When you're uncomfortable is when you grow. We know that from the gym. When you're uncomfortable is when you grow. So I like being uncomfortable in life.
Bodybuilding has been a beautiful experience for me, and I will continue it for the rest of my life. I only stopped competing, but I'm not stopping bodybuilding. It's the greatest sport. Thank you.
Arnold Schwarzenegger's mindset, and when he wants to accomplish something, he will accomplish it. And that's a prime example for all of us to look up to and realize that, you know, whatever it is we want to achieve, we can achieve it as long as we believe it and we push day after day after day. It's not just about working out, it's about life. You know, it's about accomplishing your goals.